It's radio today. It's Monday. It's 8 o'clock. This is Outspoken.
And we hope something's happening on our line right now because we've got Arafat.
Arafat on the line from PASSOP. Arafat, can you hear us?
Yeah.
Oh, welcome to Radio Outspoken. It's been a bit of a struggle to get hold of you, but thank goodness we've got hold of you eventually. Arafat, welcome to Radio Today Outspoken. Can you give us just a brief background of what PASSOP is about? It's the people, just for our listeners, PASSOP is an Afrikaans word that means to watch out, and the acronym stands for People Against Suffering, Oppression and Poverty. And just before you start, I'd just like to read out something on refugees. It says there are a very large number of immigrants living in South Africa. Estimates vary between 1 and 3 million, and many of them remain undocumented. The most vulnerable are asylum seekers, refugees, and undocumented immigrants who comprise the largest share of the immigrant population. Arafat, what is PASSOP doing about this problem in South Africa?
PASSOP, as I said, it is a non-government organization devoted to protecting and advocating rights of asylum seekers, refugees and immigrants in South Africa. In May last month, we launched the LGBTI Refugee Support Project, which is now providing advocates and support to gay and lesbians and transgender refugees and asylum seekers in South Africa. As you know, many LGBTI persons throughout Africa face unthinkable hardship. The legalization of, illegalization of homosexuality in many African countries, as well as community homophobic sentiments inhibit the safety of gays and lesbians and prevent them from leading rich and fulfilled lives. Because of suppression, many gay men and women seek refuge in South Africa, which is the only country in Africa and one of the few countries in the whole world that grants refugee status.
I was just going to ask, does South Africa specifically grant refugee status to the LGBTI community of Africa? Do we have a specific policy, or is it just because of our constitution and Bill of Rights? Because some European countries have specific policies on granting refugee status to LGBTI people.
I think in the Refugee Act, I didn't see any specific section talking about homosexuality or LGBTI people, but I think that in the other articles within the constitution, there are some where refugees, homosexuality is guaranteed and is taken as a human rights issue. I say that in this way, there are people who are recognized as refugees based on their status of being homosexual. Since we started this project, we have been interviewing people whose applications were approved, but some were rejected. So those who are rejected, I think it is a matter of sensitizing former affairs officers at refugee reception centers to know the rights of these people.
And are you a refugee yourself, or were you a refugee from an African country?
Yes, I myself am a refugee. I'm from Uganda.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. I'm a human rights activist, and I met the director of PASSOP somewhere in Cape Town. And when he called me and told me about this project, I accepted to join him because I believe that homosexuality is a human rights issue. So I have no problem with that, and I feel so okay with it.
But I believe that PASSOP was actually founded in 2007 by a group of Zimbabweans in response to the increased tension between Zimbabwe and foreign nationals, fleeing Robert Mugabe's increasingly repressive regime. In what other avenues has PASSOP progressed? Besides the Zimbabwean avenue as well as the new project of the LGBTI community, do you have other programs and other outreaches for different categories of asylum seekers and refugees and undocumented migrant workers?
Yes, from the start it was based on assisting only Zimbabweans, but right now we are extending our services to people from different countries. Since I joined PASSOP, I've been working on cases from people from Tanzania, people from Uganda, people from the Democratic Republic of Congo and other countries.
Do you also work with people from other continents, Asia, South America?
Yes, we work on them. And few days back, we helped some people from Bangladesh, and there are others from...
What are their needs? But do the people from the different continents have specific, basic, different needs?
Come again?
The people from the different continents, the refugees from Africa and the refugees from Asia, or the asylum seekers from the two continents, do they have different needs or are the needs similar?
Most of them, they got some problems because when they arrive here, they don't know where to start. So we advise them and we give them some legal advices and we refer them wherever is necessary to refer them.
Arafat, Frank here. I wanted to find out from you, what is the biggest need among refugees that come to this country seeking asylum?
The biggest?
Need.
Refugees who are coming to this country, most of them are coming to seek for protection because they face some problems in their own countries.
Mm-hmm.
Like there are those who are coming from Malawi.
Mm-hmm.
We all know Malawi. There is a problem of homophobia, which is pushed by government security personnel, So, in general, people are coming here for better protection, and those who are fleeing poverty.
Okay.
So, yes, and they come here to look for further opportunities.
Okay. Yes. At the moment, would you have statistics of how many people actually are being helped by PASSOP?
Since I joined PASSOP, I've been coming... in contact with many people. Unfortunately, right now I can't give the exact figures. But what I can say that there are many.
Okay.
Do you see an influx of refugees or asylum seekers from the Arab world with the current Arab revolutions or the Arab Spring, as it's called?
At the moment, I've not come in touch with anyone from Libya or Tunisia or Egypt.
Maybe they're still traveling down. What are the reasons why? I think we will need to go into a song and an ad and pay the rent, and then we will come back to continue this interview. But after the interview, I'd like to ask the question: what the specific reasons are why asylum seekers are rejected? But we'll discuss it after the break.
We shall be back with Arafat.
Kama huno tibadaniza Ndewi makori ya kawanda Kana uchema
zozo moyo wangu kuraziwa kana uche My name Wana Warere wakafamu sangu Apo mwe murume aripada muziko Muzidari hondo My name Wana Warere wakafamu sangu Apo mwe murume aripada muziko Muzidari hondo Tana uchema Inoto moyo wangu kuraziwa Tana uchema Inoto moyo wangu kuraziwa
Business and Arts South Africa has over 160 members. They range from the large financial and telecom institutions to diverse corporates and smaller business members. If you're passionate about the arts, BASA offers the opportunity for individuals to become members. To find out more, go onto our website www.basa.co.za.
Imagine a future without music. A future without our film industry. Such a future could be possible if we let piracy win. The Deputy Minister of Trade and Industry invites you to the anti-piracy campaign at the Walter Sisulu Square, Cliptown, on the 17th of June 2011. The campaign starts at 10 a.m. There'll be live performances by famous South African musicians and actors. Make a stand. Stop piracy before it stops our artists. Be original. Buy original. Piracy is an illegal and criminal activity. This message is brought to you by the Department of Trade and Industry in association with the creative industry.
1485 AM.
My work and my job is to defend the rights of the marginalized populations in Malawi.
This is Outspoken.
You're back with Outspoken on DSTV Audio 169, www.1485.org.za, and of course in Johannesburg on AM 1485. And we are still with Arafat from PASSOP doing our interview. Arafat, blonde moment. before the break, I asked you, what are the specific reasons why individuals are not given asylum or refugee status in South Africa?
The problem with some is language, because those who are coming from DRC, the Arabia, when they don't know how to speak English, so in this way they fail to present their cases in a fair and honest way at home affairs.
I was just going to ask, in that case, does PASSOP provide translation services? Because I see that your website is in English and French. Sorry, not translation, interpretation services.
We don't offer interpretation services, but we refer them to people who can help them. Or otherwise, we organize some people for them. But it's not part of our work, but we just do it. And there are those... others are rejected due to miscommunications between home affairs officials and those people. You know, some they free violence from their countries. They don't, when they are here in South Africa, they don't get any assistance in terms of counseling. So, some home affairs officers, they find it difficult to communicate with these people, you know.
What happens to them when they are refused asylum or refugee status?
Yeah, what happens, they get rejected, they get arrested, and they're sent to Lindela. After Lindela, they get deported back to countries where they're freed violence.
And do you tend to see that they actually, that some of them return after they've been deported and come back to South Africa again?
Some, they are deported and they come back.
They come back to South Africa?
Yeah, they come
back. So what can actually be done about the problem, not just the LGBTI problem as such, but I want to finish off on that one, but just on the general problem of the fact that a lot of refugees and asylum seekers are refused in South Africa because A, they've got a language barrier, B, they cannot present the case properly, and does that not discriminate then against those that actually can present the case properly or those that can speak English?
I didn't get you right. Can you repeat it for me?
Yeah, what I wanted to know is what can be done to assist the refugees who get discriminated against in South Africa on the basis of language and on the basis of the fact that they cannot present the case? What can specifically be done for them?
I think Home Affairs is obliged to take a stance on sensitizing with the officers, especially those working at refugee assessment centers, about refugees and asylum seekers' rights. Once this is done, I think everything will be sorted out. These problems will be sorted out.
Absolutely. We are definitely going to follow up on this story within the next few months, especially with your with the newly launched LGBTI program, and see as to the progress PASSOP has made on that issue. And we're telling the Department of Home Affairs to PASSOP. Thank you very much, Arafat.
You're welcome.
Okay, bye-bye.